This episode is sponsored by VideoBlocks.com. VideoBlocks is a fantastic, affordable stock media site that gives you unlimited access to over 100,000 video clips, After Effects templates, and spectacular motion backgrounds. Their newly launched marketplace now allows you to buy additional clips directly from their global contributor community. Your 7-day free trial gets you access to both the unlimited library and members-only pricing in the marketplace. The link is located in my video's description. Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. This tutorial is in two parts. In the first part, I'll show you how to create a custom picture frame with an inside window and an outside pattern. In part two, I'll show you how to create words that consist of colorful multi-font text. Before we begin, the picture frame filter that we'll be using in part one is only available in versions CC and later. However, the multi-layered text in part two can be done on any version of Photoshop. Create a new document by pressing Ctrl-N on Windows or Command-N on a Mac. Name it whatever you like. You can make its size whatever you'd like as well. For this example, I'll make the width 1550 pixels, the height 870 pixels, and the resolution 150 pixels per inch. Make the color mode RGB and 8 bits per channel. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Pattern. Open the pattern picker. Click the gear icon to open your pattern presets. Click Large List and click the gear icon again. Feel free to experiment with the pattern presets to ultimately get the pattern you like for your background. I'll click Color Paper. When this message pops up, click OK to replace the current patterns with the patterns you just picked. I'll choose Red Vellum and click OK. Once you have your background, you can create your border or picture frame. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. I'll rename it Picture Frame. If you're working on version CC 2014, go to Filter, Render, and Picture Frame. If you're working on version CC, press Shift plus the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open the Fill window. Check Scripted Patterns and open your list. Click Picture Frame and click OK. You can choose a multitude of types of frames. If you're choosing a vine type of frame like root, which is the frame I'm using, you can choose the vine color as well as all these other settings. You can choose the type of flower, its color and size, as well as the type of leaf and its color and size as well. Whatever frame you do choose, you want to ultimately make sure that the angle, size, and thickness are set at amounts that will completely separate the inside of your frame with the outside of your frame. You'll see why in a minute. You'll probably have to play with these settings a few times to get this right. For this example, I'll set the angle at 4, the thickness 12, the size 26, and the margin 30. Then I'll click OK. Click the FX icon and click Bevel Emboss. I'll keep everything at their default settings except the size, which I'll make 0 pixels. Click Stroke and the color box. Pick White and click OK. The size is 1 pixel and the position is outside. Change the blend mode to soft light. Then click OK. Next, we'll create the inside window. Ctrl-click or Command-click on the thumbnail of the frame to make a selection of its shape. press Q to make the selection into a quick mask. Notice your foreground and background colors are white and black, respectively. Open your Paint Bucket tool and make sure Contiguous is checked. The tolerance should be relatively low. 4 to 15 is good. Click inside the frame to remove the quick mask in that area. If it removed the quick mask outside the frame as well, it means that when you created the picture frame, there were open spaces which ultimately didn't enclose the frame itself. Remember, the frame's angle, size, and thickness should be set at amounts that completely separate the inside of your frame with the outside of the frame. Once you've successfully created a frame that does this, at this point, press Q again to revert the quick mask back into a selection. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the empty layer. Drag the layer below the picture frame. We'll fill the empty layer with any color. I'll fill it with white. Click the FX icon and choose Pattern Overlay. Open the Pattern Picker and pick any light color. I'm picking white textured. In part 2, I'll show you how to add colorful, multi-font text for your words. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.